Blackstone Publishing presents Alien Prototype by Tim Waggoner. This book is read by Sarah Mollo-Christensen. 1. Holy shit. Tamar Prather said the words so softly, someone would have had to be crouching alongside her to think she'd done more than exhale. Normally, her self-control was so complete that this slight lapse was the equivalent of screaming at the top of her lungs. Given the cause, she decided she could forgive herself, this once. The stasis pod had no identifying marks, no manufacturer's symbol, no serial number, but it was top-of-the-line tech, likely a Weyland-Yutani product. The container was 3 feet high and just as wide. Basically square, although its edges were rounded. Probably for aesthetic effect, Tamar guessed. The company's designers were big on extra touches like that, thought it set their products apart from their competitors. She'd found the pod hidden in a storage compartment built into the floor of the captain's quarters. Although hidden was a misnomer. She'd spotted the seams in the floor the moment she'd walked into the cabin, hadn't even needed to use the omni-scanner she held in her left hand. Employing the tool to unlock the compartment, she removed the top panel and then scanned the pod to determine what lay inside. The shielding prevented a detailed readout, but the result, though woefully incomplete, displayed on the screen. One word. Biomatter. This could be it, she thought. The holy fucking grail.
How's it going, Tamar? You find anything?
Jumping a bit, she turned her head to see Juan Varela standing in the open doorway. He was tall and muscular, with a shaved head and a black mustache and goatee that were badly in need of trimming. He wore black pants and boots, but his pride was an ancient brown leather jacket held together with generous applications of Insta-Seal and prayer. The big man's eyes fixed on the storage pod still resting in the open floor compartment, and his mouth stretched into a wide grin.
I love stasis pods, he said, especially when they're hidden like that. Means there's something important inside, and that means credits. Lots and lots of...
Tamar's body acted on its own, with no input from her conscious mind. She jumped to her feet and spun, drawing the Fournier 350 from her side holster. No need to disengage the weapon's safety. She never left it on. The pistol was set to silent mode, a must in her line of work, and the weapon emitted two soft chuffs as she put a pair of bullets into Juan's forehead. The man stiffened, a look of confusion on his face, which seemed only natural since he'd just had his brains turned into slurry, and then he crumpled as if he were a synthetic experiencing a complete system shutdown. Prather was strong, but Juan was too massive for her to catch. Instead, she dashed forward, rammed him with her shoulder, and directed his falling body onto the bunk. He hit the thin mattress with a thud, but the impact was muffled, and she doubted anyone else on the ship could hear it. She gazed down at Juan's corpse. He'd landed face down and hung halfway off the side. Not the most dignified of deaths, but Tamar had seen, and caused, worse in her career. She had acted on instinct, but if she'd taken the time to consider her actions, the result would have been the same. There was no way she could let her companions know what was, what might be, inside the stasis pod. Still holding her gun, Tamar crouched next to the open storage compartment and touched the omni-scanner to the pod's surface again. The pod's control system was locked, of course, but the scanner, while not as good perhaps as a Weyland-Yutani product, was more than capable of granting her access. After several seconds, she was in, and she used the scanner's touchscreen to send the pod a command. Servo motors engaged, small black wheels emerged from the pod's bottom and sides, and the pod began to climb out of the compartment. Stasis pods this size were too heavy to lift, so they came equipped with movement assist tech. Tamar stood and faced the open doorway as the pod made its way up and onto the cabin floor. Tucking the omni-scanner into a loop next to the comm on the side of her belt, she kept her gun trained on the door in case any more.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.